reading book together. The complex number x minus a root of y is called the conjugate of z is equal to x plus a root of y. That is, suppose if we have any complex number x plus a root of y, then its conjugate is actually this sort of number x minus a root of y will be called conjugate of x plus a root of y. It will be denoted by this z bar, and z bar is this complex number x minus a root of y. If you see graphically, z conjugate is reflection or conjugation of z about the real axis. Suppose if you have x plus a root of y over here, if you see x plus a root of y over here, then its conjugate will actually lie, you know, it will be symmetric about x-axis. Here you can see this is z bar is equal to x minus a root of y. If you see, in my opinion, how I see conjugate and I see how I define the conjugate of a complex number, so I definitely you will enjoy that. Actually, I see conjugate as a function, and its inputs are complex and its outputs are complex. That is, whenever we put any complex number in conjugate function, it returns us this x minus a root of y. For example, if in conjugate function, if you put any complex number 1 plus a root of y in z conjugate, we will get 1 minus a root of y. Here we have plus, so here we will have minus. So if we call this conjugate as a function, so let me then name it properly. Suppose as this function requires inputs from complex, so I call this function as f of z, and I denote it by z bar. So actually this is a complex valued function because outputs are complex. Here you can see, and inputs are complex. Okay, so we go on with the study. Okay, obviously if you see that z modulus or z absolute, we know that what was its formula, x square plus y square. Of course, that was the formula of the modulus or absolute. And it is interesting to note that if you multiply x plus a root of y with x minus a root of y, you get the same value, x square plus y square. So from here we deduce that z modulus is actually same as z into z bar. So here there is a small mistake here in the, so it's okay, we can ignore that. So if you see that z modulus or z absolute is equal to z into z bar. Okay, so we have this property now. So I have told you how z modulus is equal to x square plus y square square root. And similarly, if you multiply z into z bar, x plus a root of y into x minus a root of y, you again get the same result. So we can say that z modulus is equal to this. Similarly, we have another identity that if we add any complex number is x plus a root of y with its conjugate x minus a root of y, so minus a root of y and positive a root of y will be cancelled, and 2x divided by 2 we will get x. So it means that it is the real of z. Of course, x is called real part of z. So we have that, you know, sort of, whenever we have this quantity, we will get x. And if we subtract it, like x plus a root of y minus x minus a root of y, and do this subtraction divided by 2 a root, we will get definitely y. So we have this identity as well. Okay, so this is what I'm reading the book for increasing the knowledge. So any Cartesian equation, so what is the benefit of that? You know, what is the benefit? Okay, can we use this in a calculation? This sort of few lines, yes, we can use such things in calculation. For example, so any Cartesian equation f of x, y is equal to 0 can be written in complex variable. That is why simply replace x by z plus z bar from here, the above, z plus z bar divided by 2 square plus, and y can be replaced by z minus z bar divided by 2 iota square is equal to a square. So it means that any you know, Cartesian equation can be replaced by this complex equation. So this is really interesting, which after a little simplification takes the shape z bar is equal to a square. So this can be further written in this form. Okay.